Greetings gamers, my name is Johnny Retro and welcome back to another episode of Retro Raider. That's right, today I have another review of a brand new JRPG indie pixel art game. Today we are going to take a closer look at Celestial Hearts. I was very lucky to get an early access to this game. I've been playing it for the past week and yeah, this is my review. This game was developed and published by the game designer Joshua Keith and it saw the light of day after a very successful Kickstarter campaign. Now the thing with Celestial Hearts is that, well, this game is a Yuri story driven game. And in case you guys don't know what a Yuri game is all about, well, check this out. Yuri games are generally considered as a category of games that the theme of them focus on Yuri relationships and stories. In Japan, well, we're talking about relationships between two female characters. I know, but I mean guys, it's 2021, okay? No one cares. Usually the Yuri theme is more present in mangas and visual novels, but well, this JRPG is indeed a Yuri JRPG. So first things first, let's start with the story. Deep within the continent of Belum lies Livia, a small village of nymphs and fairies. Keiha, a young elf and guardian of Livia, is slowly recovering from the loss of her partner. One fateful night, the village is raided by the Gravehearts, an ultra-rich and powerful family that all but owns Belum. Keiha, her friend Sylvie, and the nymphs wake up in an underground prison. During their escape, they find a winged woman chained up and passed out. After escaping and nursing the angel back to health, they learn that her name is Helen. And little else besides that, she is aware of a purpose she cannot remember. Keiha, feeling drawn to Helen, vows to keep her safe as they flee from the Gravehearts. But the two, alongside their friends Sylvie, Gail, and Matthias, note that they can't run forever. What is Ellen's purpose and how it is connected to the Graveheart family? And more importantly, what is this indescribable feeling between Helen and the elf who was sworn to protect her? In the end, well, a love story between two chicks, but the thing is that the story is actually very good, it is very well written. And the pacing of the game for me, that is what made me play this game from start to finish. And let me tell you guys, I really enjoy Celestial Hearts. And about the gameplay, well, this is of course a 2D pixel art game with an active time battle side view turn-based combat system. And in total, we have a party of 5 heroes. The interesting thing about this game is that we can play it on the keyboard, of course, but we can also play the entire thing with just a mouse. And you guys know me, I mean, I'm a console gamer, okay? I'm a console guy, I need my controller. On PC, yeah, I usually play with keyboard and mouse, and this game, I don't know, it just feels right to play it with the mouse. It just plays very well. I mean, in terms of movement, you can move the character pretty much in every direction you want, you just point and click pretty much. It's easy to navigate through the menus, it's easy to use the mouse, you know, in combat. You still kinda need the keyboard just a little bit, but let me tell you that playing this game with the mouse, it feels right. Difficulty, we have 3 different difficulty levels to choose from. I went with the easiest one, which is the story mode. I mean, I just wanted really to explore the story of this game. And yeah, in terms of combat, it was easy. But if you want a challenge, you also have a hard mode. And let me tell you, a couple of bosses in the game are pretty tough. The combat system is very intuitive and it is very versatile and each character is a unique character in combat. We have a lot of spells, a lot of standard attacks, special abilities, special attacks, etc. We also have a variety of gear and items to boost our heroes. Overall, I think that we are talking about between 12 to 16 hours of gameplay in total. Of course, that will depend in which difficulty you play the game. Now, I want to talk about the graphics, because you guys know, usually in these type of 2D pixel art games, the graphics is, you know, the thing that caught my attention. And yeah, the graphics are good, are very good, very inspired in old-school 16-bit graphics, but it isn't forced, you know, it doesn't try to copy anything, it's pretty much its own thing. The sprites are big, the backgrounds are very sharp, I like the animations also. We also have enemy-styled characters in dialogues, and they actually change their facial expressions. I just have 2 small complaints about the graphics. Well, the first one is that, you know, the sprite models of the characters in combat, I mean, the heroes just don't look that great compared to the enemies. I don't know, they just don't blend that well in combat. And the other thing is the world map view. I mean, the characters just look very big. As a matter of fact, it's the same size in the world map as in, you know, the rest of the game. The game looks good, guys, don't get me wrong, but these are just 2 small picking complaints, you know, for my personal taste. And about the enemies and the boss battles, I mean, they look great. Very detailed, a variety and a lot of original enemies and mobs to fight with. They're very polished, it's a mixture of, you know, hand drawing with pixel art. Yeah, it's a great, good looking 2D pixel art game. And about the music, well, in any game, but especially on an RPG, music is crucial for me. And if the graphics look good, the music sounds even better. I just loved the entire soundtrack of Celestial Hearts. Very original. I mean, again, it doesn't try to copy anything that it was made in the past. It is original and, I don't know, you just feel right at home. You know, if you played games like Chrono Trigger, Secret of Mana, stuff like that, you have your classic theme for each situation, you know, the battle theme, you have the town theme, inn theme. It's really a great soundtrack. And it sounds modern, because let's not forget, it is a 2D pixel art game, but it is a modern game. I mean, it's 2021. In the end, it's a simple JRPG. It is very story-driven, so it is kinda of a linear game, but the story and the very fun and intuitive battle system is what is going to make you play and keep going with the game. So final thoughts, did I enjoy Celestial Hearts? I absolutely did. Do I recommend this game for you guys? Well, again, if you grew up playing classic 16-bit JRPGs, I think that you will enjoy this one. I mean, if you're looking for, you know, an indie and quick and easy JRPG to grab your hands on, give this one a go. Celestial Hearts is being released today on Steam, so go check it out. This was the review, guys. I really hope that you guys have enjoyed this video, and please let me know down below if you guys are planning to grab your hands on Celestial Hearts. And don't forget, if you have the extra time, feel free to follow me on social media. I'm on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to put a like on this video. Please subscribe to the channel and take care of yourselves. Take care of the gaming community and game a lot.